You know, I can't imagine how beautiful it must be at Stanford. San Francisco, an amazing city, prestigious university. I mean, it really should be the best time of their lives for the students there. But they're getting all revved up about hating Israel. It just seems out of place to me. Who's organizing this? And as I was just saying to you before we turned the camera on, I suppose this is an infection in every campus around North America, not just, for example, in San Francisco there.
Yeah, I don't think it's exclusive to the Palo Alto area at all. There's a group of students gathered just behind me, and they've put up these wall barricades, somehow pretending to simulate Israel, like the walls in Israel are some evil thing. And they're trying to walk this line where they say it's not anti-Semitic to be anti-Zionist. And that's the line that they're trying to walk. Of course, time will tell once I actually go up and talk to them and speak with them and figure out what is behind their drive, why they're taking off time in the middle of exam week to put up these walls to spread this pro-Palestine, pro-Hamas, well, I shouldn't say pro-Hamas, pro-Palestine story.
Yeah, you know what? I agree that every country in the world should be open to criticism. Lord knows I criticize Canada, and I'm not an anti-Canadian bigot. I criticize it because I lived here and I want it to be better, and I have a certain philosophy that would make Canada great. I don't believe in destroying Canada. And here's my thoughts on anti-Zionism. And when people say, I'm not anti-Semitic, I have no problem with Jews, it's just Israel I don't like. If someone were to say, I'm anti-Italy, and it's all they would talk about, and they would nitpick Italy, and they would boycott pizza. I can't even imagine anyone who would do that. And pasta, I mean, my God, I mean, I know we're deep into hypothetical territory here. And they just wouldn't shut up about Italy. And and they would just boycott anything made in Italy. I'd say, you know what? I think you got a problem with Italians, mate. I mean, every country has their flaws. Italy, I could name you five, but if all you do is you bash Italy and things made in Italy, and you don't like the Italian teams in sports, and you don't like Italian professors coming over, and you try and boycott tour, I think you're a bit of an anti-Italian bigot. That's what I would say if someone was really weird anti-Italy or anti-Spain or anti-Ireland. I think that these folks are obsessed by Israel, and they don't care about any of the world's other 200 countries. I think it's something besides politics. I think they don't like Jews.
I would agree with you there, Ezra. There's a Christian guy. I got to just give you some context to what I'm listening to right now. And I don't know if you can hear it on the mic, but there's a Christian preacher who is set up right in front of the apartheid wall that the Palestinians have put up, and he's just spouting off about Donald Trump and illegal aliens. But he has this Alex Jones shirt on, so I'm really excited to go talk to him to see what brought him out to this protest, this Palestinian protest, because I'm sure it's not a coincidence that he's standing out here. And I'm also interested to chat with the students that are here, that are walking by, sort of glancing at this wall, and they continue walking, or if they stop and talk with the guys. I want to know what the average Stanford student thinks about this apartheid wall that is set up. I'm not sure which way they're. I have a feeling that they're not really going to know what it is about. I don't think that the majority of Stanford students are anti-Semitic, but you know they all like to be progressive. They all like to be with what's hip, so they might just go along to get along. So I'm going to chat with them and see what they end up saying about it.
That's an excerpt from the Ezra Levant Show. Every day, I do a video monologue, and then I interview an interesting guest, and then I end by reading my hate mail. But you've got to subscribe to it, which you can do at therebel.media/shows.